Hello students, so today we shall start with the next part of the representative uses of the computer graphics. So in the previous part we have seen up to the representation graphics, so from now onwards, so now we'll see the entertainment is one such representative use of the computer graphics. So where we all are familiar, the movie industry, the gaming industry, all are very good example of where all the graphics is getting used. So it uses motion pictures, musics, videos and television shows, and the most popular one is the cartoon animation films are the fruits of how the computer graphics has become the part and parcel of our entertainment also. And then you can see the graphics is about animation, and there you can see anything that can be visualized, any drawing that is done with help of a sketch pencil, that can be visualized in the digitally, it can be visualized by using the computer graphics programs, and we can get the graphics done. And the gaming industry, in the gaming industry the very important thing is, so the game starts becoming more and more interactive in the sense, so how you behave, so how you give the input exactly, the game is played and it gets back you the result of, that is the interaction between the gamer and the gaming program. So it is so very continuously going process. So in this, so the program has to be very sophisticated and it has to be very technically strong, so that it makes the interaction so very well with the animations and with the sounds and with the videos and with the interactions that the user is doing with the game. So all this becomes very important. And then more computation is not expected in the gaming, so you are not expected to do some computations, but the interaction is done, and the computer gaming, it behaves as you give the input to or as you interact with the gaming. And then going to the next representative use is the education and the training. So as per the education and the training is considered, so the computer generated models, so that are physical, financial, economic systems, so all are a very important things, so that works as aids, that is helping this education industry actually. So education, so the full whole institution, so it can use the models, the physical models and all the financial models, economic models, to get the training to the students. And the models are something like the population trends or any equipments, or mathematically models can be designed. So many times mathematically when we are speaking, so the things may not be visualized to the students, so using the computer graphics the models can be prepared, and the maths which is more abstract can become more materialistic, and the student can understand the concept very well. And then the education and the training, so in that, so we will have the concept of the simulation. So simulation in the sense, say for example, the pilot has to be trained, a pilot has to be trained for the aircraft, that is aircraft is manufactured, and the pilot is not given with the real aircraft, and he doesn't fly the real aircraft. So what he is made to do is, so he goes to the simulation. So simulation in the sense, it is a working model, it is the working model. So there in the slide, in the image, you can see the driver is given with the model, and he gets a virtual environment of how the craft is, how the aircraft is going to be, or how the car is going to be when I really drive it. So all the real experience you get it in this virtual simulation, and therefore, so for training, so it is the very best thing that we can use. And the heavy equipment like traffic, in traffic air control and heavy equipment operators, so they cannot be given directly with the real manufactured item, and then the training has to be done with the help of simulation only. So simulation is very important in training. So next, coming the next part of the representative use is the computer art. So as we know, graphics is mainly, it is the drawing that we always visualize whenever we hear the word graphics. So in the same way, the computer art has emerged very very proficiently so in this area. So the cartoonists have found it so very easy to design the cartoons. The painters have found it so very easy to design the paintings and digitalize it. So the packages that are available here in this computer art, so they are meant for the fine art and all the commercial art. So the paintbrush programs, paint packages, CAD packages and animation packages, so they are all of a very important aspect. So whenever we say art is considered, so art has enhanced a lot with the help of this computer graphics. You can see that the advertisements, cartoons, drawings, everything has enhanced so realistically that the whole image, whichever I visualize in my imagination, so I can bring it to the display screen so very well. Okay, so then the electronic painting is what, just a simple painting that we can say. In the same way, the next example is a morphing. So morphing is the graphics method in which one object is transformed into another object. So here you can see the example, so where a face can be transformed into another type of animal or anything. So that is keeping the same image, so we can transform it to a very different type, or here animal is getting transformed into a face of a woman like. So this is called as morphing. So this is also one of the computer art that we can say. And the visualization is next representative use of it. So in this visualization, what happens is, so medical field and the law field, so all can make use of it. And the visualization of the whole concept, so it is very well utilized in the medical field. So that we can see in the next part. Thank you.